First of all, let's see what we did it in the last class, and then we'll start the today's class, right? So in the last class, we learned about the knowledge engineering. What is knowledge engineering? Basically, I'll give you a quick recap. In knowledge engineering, we learned about, you know, how this FOL is actually implemented in the system, how it is inbuilt into the AI system that we learned, and the procedure is known as, you know, knowledge engineering, and the person who did it is called is known as knowledge engineer. So this we all covered in the last class, how it is done. So in the today's class, now once the knowledge engineering done with their steps, means when the knowledge based system is prepared fully and it is now ready to use. So ready to use means, you know, from the knowledge system, what we are doing, what we expect, we want to get something out of it. So that is what we call inference in the first order logic. इन्फ्रेंस का मतलब मैंने आपको बताया ही था. इन्फ्रेंस का मतलब होता है निष्कर्ष निकालना. तो हमने लास्ट क्लास में जो पढ़ा था उसमें हमने पढ़ा था कि नॉलेज बेस के अंदर ये FOL कैसे डाला जाता है. तो आज हम पढ़ेंगे FOL तो डल गया उसके अंदर, मतलब जो स्टेटमेंट्स हैं कैसे उसको हम यूज करके प्रेडिक्ट और उसको करते हैं. आज हम उस जो नॉलेज को हमने उस सिस्टम के अंदर बिल्ड कर दिया, नाउ हाउ टू गेट यू नो आउट ऑफ इट, हम उससे आउटपुट कैसे लेंगे. तो इसके भी कुछ सर्टेन रूल्स हैं. देर आर सर्टेन रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस यू नो विच इज़ यूज फॉर इन्फ्रेंस टू गेट द इन्फ्रेंस इन FOL. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. इन्फ्रेंस इन FOL इज़ यूज टू डिड्यूस न्यू फैक्ट और सेंटेंसेज फ्रॉम द एग्जिस्टिंग सेंटेंस डैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट डैट टू गेट एन आउटपुट. दिस इज़ वट वी इन द सिंपल टर्म्स वट वी कॉल्ड यू नो टू गेटिंग एन आउटपुट. So before understanding the FOL inference rule, let's understand some basic terminologies used in FOL. Number one is substitution. Now what is substitution? Substitution is a fundamental operation performed on terms and formulas. It occurs in all inference systems in FOL. The substitution is complex in the presence of quantifier in FOL. If we write, you know, F A by X, it means A can be substituted with X. So it refers to the substitute at a constant A in a place of variable X. So this is a way, you know, how to write the substitution values. You have to write the value that has to be substituted with the value that gets substituted. So A by X. So this is what we call, you know, substitution. This is one of the way. A by X, how to substitute the values in the FOL. Another very important rule is equality. Equality means sometimes, you know, we're talking about somebody and we want to say that is this thing is also applicable to somebody else. So there we used equality. So FOL does not only use predicate and the term of making atomic sentences, but also there is a they use another way, which is equality in FOL. For this we can use equality symbols, and everybody knows equality symbol is equal to, like if somebody writes brother zone is equal to Smith. So as the above example, the object referred by the brother John is similar to the object referred by Smith, because if we say brother John is a brother of Smith, definitely the Smith is also on the other hand, Smith is also a brother of John. So the equality symbol can also be used with negation also to represent that the two terms are not equal. Like this, if we put a negation symbol in the front of the equal, it means they are not equal. This is equivalent to this thing. So I hope you all understand there are two ways. And two basically operations, one is substitution and another is equality, that is very commonly used in FOL. So let's move forward. Yeah, this is very important. FOL inference rules for quantifier, and our main focus of this class is on this. FOL inference rule for quantifiers. See, these are the general rules. If somebody asks you what are the FOL rules, then you have to say one is substitution, in which you, if you want to substitute one thing with another, you can do it. And another is equality, where one thing is equal to another. If you want to equate two things together, you can use equality. So now there are four another, you know, FOL rules. This is very important. As propositional logic, we also have the inference rules in FOL, like we already, you know, learned about the propositional rules in first order logic. So following are some basic inference rules in FOL. There are some basic rules in FOL. Number one is universal generalization. What it means, and maybe this question will be asked to you in your exam. What are the FOL inference rule for quantifiers, particularly for quantifier? Quantifier we already covered. One is this symbol, that is what we called for all, and another one is this symbol. Opposite E, you may say it is a reflection of E. So this is what we call for sum. So there are two symbols, basically two quantifiers. One is for all, another is for sum. So, and this is a limitation in propositional logic. Basically, in propositional logic, we can't, you know, express the statements for all or for sum. So this is the problem in the propositional logic. That is why we move for predicate logic, or another what we call it FOL, first order logic. Mind it, ek cheez aap apne dimag mein aaj fir acche se clear kar lijiye. Do cheeze hoti hain knowledge base represent ko represent karne ke liye method hai. False logic, जो हमने conjunction, negation, and or logical जो भी operations थे जो हमने पढ़े थे, that is comes under propositional logic. In predicate logic, there is a, you know, predicate and a sentence, and predicate logic को ही दूसरा नाम FOL है, जिसको कि हम first order logic कहते हैं. So universal generalization जो है वो प्रेडिकेट लॉजिक का ही एक पार्ट है, जिसको कि एफओएल का भी एक पार्ट है. कभी कभार मैं एफओएल को आई यूज़, यू नो, इन माय लेक्चर समटाइम्स आई यूज एफओएल, समटाइम्स आई से प्रेडिकेट लॉजिक. सो बोथ मीनिंग्स आर सेम, माइंड इट. सो लेट्स कवर द यूनिवर्सल जनरलाइजेशन. यूनिवर्सल जनरलाइजेशन इज अ वैलिड इन्फ्रेंस रूल फॉर स्टेट विच स्टेट्स दैट इफ प्रमाइस पी सी इज ट्रू फॉर एन आर्बिट्रेरी कॉन्स्टेंट एलिमेंट सी in the universe of discourse, then we can have a conclusion that it is true for all. Yes, this is very important. Just wait. Yeah, this is very important. If you say a rule for all, then obviously it is applicable for all the things. So it is represented by this, like if it is true for premises like this, then it is true for all. We will see it. This rule can be, you know, used if we want to show that every element have similar property, and in this rule x must be appear as a free variable. Okay, so let's see the example. Let's represent PC means premise as a byte contains 8 bit. So a byte contains 8 bit, it means we can conclude it like all bytes contain 8 bit. Because it is not a, you know, particular byte which have 8 bits. Every byte in this world having 8 bits, so it will also be true. So this is an inference basically. If somebody says a byte contains 8 bits, so we conclude from this statement that every byte in this world is 8 bit. That is why it is called universal generalization. Generalization means if it is not specific to a particular thing, it is for all. So I think everybody understands universal generalization. So let's move towards the next one, universal instantiation. Now this is how it is pronounced. It is instantiation. Okay, let me ask somebody else how it is pronounced. Yes, Yashvi, इसको कैसे पढ़ेंगे बेटे? This word.
Sir, instantiation.
Instantiation, right? So sometimes it is somebody you know get mixed with instantiation. No, it is instantiation, right? So okay, so let's move this universal instantiation. What is this? Universal instantiation is also called as universal elimination or UI. Don't get you know mixed with UI user interface. This is universal elimination. So is a valid inference rule. It can apply it multiple times to add new sentences. The new knowledge base is logically equivalent to the previous knowledge base. As per UI, we can inference any sentence obtained by substituting a ground terms for the variable. So let's you know understand this with an example. The how this universal generalization is different from universal instantiation. See, universal generalization, there is a premise is at the numerator and we write you know the general term at the denominator. Here it is just reversed. Your premise is at the you know at the bottom at the denominator and the general term is at the numerator. Okay, let's understand this with an example. If I'm saying if every person's like ice cream, every person like ice cream, this is a general rule. So we can take an instant is what you know instance means a particular person. If we are talking about a particular man or woman, that is what we call instance. And number of instance means how many you know how many times you are using that particular thing. Like if I'm saying every person, so every person may be a John, like John like ice cream, we can conclude it Yashika can like ice cream, we can conclude Nischal can like ice cream, or Anurag likes ice cream. So because the general statement is this, every person like ice cream. So by general, if the general statement is like this, so we can you know create any instance of that general statement. So this is what we call universal instantiation. So I think you understand. In the previous one, universal generalization, there is a general sentence, right? There is not a general sentence. There is a basically a particular sentence, and we generalize it for all. And in universal instantiation, it is just opposite to that. Here we have a general statement, and we can create a instance as we want. Basically, you know, this is a general statement. After that, you can write King John, greedy John, means all kings who are greedy. So John, who is greedy, is also evil. By the same thing, Richard. I think everybody understand this. This is very easy. So till now, if anybody have any question, any query, you may ask me. Anybody? Okay, let me quickly see. Okay. I think nobody have no question. Okay, Mohammad Asif se hum poochte hain. Mohammad Asif, what do you understand by these two, you know, universal instantiation and universal generalization?
Sir, universal generalization hota hai ki basically hum kehte hain ki if PC premise is true, then any arbitrary element jo C se hoga, universal discourse mein true hoga.
Right.
We say ki for all of x, px will be true. So for example, हम कहते हैं कि एक one second sir. जी सर.
Yes.
हम कहते हैं कि PC if we say a byte contain 8 bits, then for universe के अंदर हर byte 8 contain ही bit contain करेगा. All bytes contain 8 bits.
Very good, very good.
also true.
Right.
Now the second one is universal instantiation. We say ki if every person like ice cream, so we say every person will take any of the instance for that. Any of the person like we take a name. John likes ice cream.
Yeah.
And so, the second one you said all kings are who are greedy are evil. So any of the king who is greedy, that will be evil.
Very good. Great. I think there is a lot of noise is coming from your house. No problem. But you explained it correctly. It means you are attentive, right? Very good. So universal generalization and universal instantiation. I think everybody understands this. Now let's move towards the next two. Existential instantiation and existential introduction. So existential instantiation, let me start this. Yeah. Existential instantiation is also tension. Universal instantiation. So let's see. Existential means it is for some, obviously, and is also called existential elimination, which is a valid inference rule in the FOL. It can be applied only once to replace the existential sentence. The new knowledge base is not logically equivalent to the old knowledge base, but it will be satisfiable if old knowledge base was satisfiable. So, okay, the rule states that one can inference from the formula given in the form of this for the new constant symbol C. The restriction with this rule is that C used in the rule must be a new term for which PC is true. So it is represented by it can be represented as this. So for example, let's understand this by an example. So for a given sentence like crown, head, John, so we can inference like crown on head, crown k John, as long as k does not appear in the knowledge base. So basically it is for some, this is for some, we can use it for some. The above use k constant is a symbol which is called Skolem constant. This is very important, Skolem constant. And the existential instantiation is special case of Skolemization process. So basically this is the it is not in your course, but you should have to understand Skolem constant and Skolemization process is it deals with simple existential instantiation. So let's move towards the next last one. Existential introduction is also known as existential generalization, which is a valid inference rule in FOL. This rule states that if there is some element C in the universe of discourse, it is just like the opposite of this. Just like we did it here in universal generalization. So existential introduction is also called existential generalization. So it is also called existential generalization. So let's see here it is clearly mentioned. And existential introduction is also for known as existential generalization, which is a valid inference rule in the FOL. This rule says that if there is a sum C in the universe of discourse which has a property P, then we can infer that there exists something in the universe which has a property of P, and it is represented like this. Like let's say an example, Priyanka got good marks in English, therefore someone got good marks in English. So because in someone Priyanka will come, because Priyanka is one of the in someone. So we can write it like this. So this is same like we did it earlier. So I hope you all understand this. So there are four rules. One is universal generalization, another is universal instantiation, then existential instantiation, and existential introduction or existential generalization. So let's move towards the last topic for the today's class. This is very important. I hope everybody understand this. The only thing is, the first two rules is for, you know, this is for the universal means for all, and these two all for some, that is what we call existential, right? So let's move toward the last topic of the today's class, that is generalized modus ponens rule. See, modus ponens, it is one of the very important rule in FOL. We already, you know, did the same thing in the propositional logic. If you remember this, we already did the modus ponens rules in the generalization also. Although it is not in your course, but you should have to understand that the modus ponens rules is also applicable for FOL. How? We'll see. For the inference process in the FOL, we have a single inference rule, which is called generalized modus ponens. It is lifted version of modus ponens. Generalized modus ponens can be summarized as like P implies Q, and P is asserted to be true, therefore Q must be true. So mathematically it is represented, you know, like this. If it is true, and we can, you know, means if P implies Q is true and P asserted to be true, therefore Q must be P of Q, and P is handsome. P is something. P is not a liar. This implies Q is also not a liar. That means P and Q are this. How it is interrelated. So this is an example here. Let's say P1 is a king, P2 is greedy. So we may say, Q is also evil. If P is evil, then Q is also evil. So I hope everybody understands this. This is very easy. So this is very important, and you must have to cover this thing in the, you know, for your exam. Let's write one question, and then we'll end this class, because, you know, another faculty member has to be set up their own, you know, system. So let's write quickly. First question. What are the various inference rules in FOL? What are the various inference rule in FOL? So let me quickly ask the answer from you all. See, whenever somebody asks you what are the various inference rule, you should have to mention, you know, these four you have to mention, right? These are the rules. And if somebody asks you what are the fundamental operations, next question, write down, next question, what are the fundamental operations performed in inference in FOL? Right, so you have to mention the substitution as well as the equality. I hope all understand this. So, and the last question, very important. You just write it for your reference. What is generalized modus ponens? Maybe.